in Texas, OBGYNs, they want to leave the state, put it a full mask. This is what you call your bad governing at work. Texas already ranks 50th in the state for women's health outcomes. Now, OBGYNs in Texas want to leave the state for good. Since 2022, Texas has threatened abortion providers with life in prison. And before the total ban, Texas became the first state to enforce the six-week ban. Now, we know the impact of these laws. In September, NBC published the first maternal mortality data from Texas since SB 8 took effect in September 2021 and found maternal deaths in the state increased by a staggering 56%. Do you hear me? 56% from 2019 to 2022 compared to an 11% increase nationwide during the same time period. Now, a new survey out this week shows the state of maternal health in Texas is on track to become worse. The survey conducted by Manet Health received responses from 450 practicing doctors and 47 medical residents in Texas, with 70% saying the state's abortion ban prohibits them from providing high-quality, evidence-based care. Even more concerning, a fifth of respondents said they've considered leaving Texas, and 13% said they plan to retire early as a result of the abortion ban. The majority of OBGYN residents said Texas abortion laws can be a factor in whether they stay in the state. Further, a third of the respondents said they don't understand what exactly qualifies as life-threatening under the abortion ban's narrow and ambiguous exception for medical emergencies, while 6% said they fear legal repercussions for providing any basic healthcare services that could be associated with abortion. We've reported on these stories initially when the bill actually became law. And during that time, women were denied life-saving medical services because the medical director did not want to risk misinterpreting or did not want to risk it being misinterpreted what service was provided, because the penalty for this political dynamic can be life in prison. It's a horrible reality to face. But this is what, once again, bad governing gets you. These are the consequences, okay? The same day that particular health company published this study, a group of Texas OBGYNs spoke to reporters at an event hosted by the Texas Democratic Party. Quote, "We found that maternal mortality is going up. We found that infant mortality is going up." Houston-based OBGYN Dr. Damla Carson said, adding that these are all the results of the state's total abortion ban. Now, here you go. A direct conflict in their alleged reason for providing the ban. You have more harm, death, and now you have an industry leaving the state. And here's the stat they don't know yet. How many would-be doctors are saying, "I'm not going to be an OBGYN because of this law"? You see, this is what happened. How do you think we got to the teacher shortage in America? We got there because governments routinely disrespected teachers by way of pay and benefit. And so what happened? Folks stopped going to college to become teachers. And you got a teacher shortage now. So this permeates beyond the statistical data they can read to you now. Currently, more than 45% of Texas counties are classified as maternal care deserts due to the lack of doctors providing parental services and the lack of places to give birth. Unsurprisingly, in a country with the worst maternal mortality rate among wealthy nations, Texas ranks 50th among all states and DC for women's health outcomes, according to a recent study from the Commonwealth Fund. Medical students are less likely to apply for residence in Texas. Now, another study from May found U.S. medical students are less likely to apply to residency programs in states with abortion bans, while a survey from December showed three quarters of future U.S. doctors say abortion bans are a key factor in whether they apply for residencies. In Idaho, where abortion is totally banned, the state is in the midst of a maternal care crisis. Since 2022, Idaho has lost a quarter of all OBGYNs, over half of its maternal and fetal medicine specialists, and three labor and delivery wards. They no longer have the expertise. Why would more women die? Why would more children die? Because the doctors you have in your state, they don't possess the expertise. That's why. Because your politicians decided to play games with your very life. Now, I want to appeal to every single woman. And frankly, we should appeal to every single human being, because nobody got here without a woman. They don't care. They're killing people, literally, with policy. They don't care. Politics aside, at a point, your humanity has to rise above it. These individuals will be okay with you dying in order for them to maintain a proxy of power. But you actually have the ultimate power. And this is why they manipulate the facts and they manipulate your minds, because they know at the end of the day, you actually hold the power. And so they have to manipulate you so that you can keep giving them power. Don't give people power who don't deserve your respect. Sharon, thoughts?
I'm just over it, because then once the women die, they condescendingly and callously tell you it's your fault. They said, right. I had a fight with a Republican friend last week. I hung the phone up on him, who said, well, it's the Democrats who aren't explaining that it's, you know, you're just not explaining. The law is adequate. And I had to tell them that, well, doctors who are those experts, as you referenced, Doc, who are being driven out of Iowa, don't want to lose their whole careers. And they have lawyers at hospitals. Okay. Yep, people think the Lincoln Project's ad, that it starts out all nice and then says you would have been the best grandfather and everything and la da 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 da. And then at the end, it's shocking. But I'm dead, Dad, because you voted for hate is going too far. I don't think it's far enough. Put the fathers who lost a daughter on. Put the actual fathers, not actors. I don't think it goes far enough. This is actually reality. We know that here in Georgia, don't we?
That's right. Well said. All right. We'll bring you updates. I guarantee more updates are to come because of these disastrous laws.